360 TV.
Hey, how's it going, J360 Legion? What is happening? Welcome to Project Conference 4. I'm your host, J-Man, of course, and we got a spectacular show happening for you all. And you know, I've been looking forward to this. I've been meaning to interview this band on this show for quite some time. I always had it in mind for them to be number four on this one. And it is the legendary cyber pop rock duo known as Ardenite. And I'm going to tell you this, you guys are in for a special treat this time. So, without any further ado, let's go ahead and bring them in. Okay. Hey, how's it going, Ardenite? What is up? Awesome.
Yes.
Hello.
Sebo Green. Nice.
Yeah. Finally seeing you face to face, Jay. I'm really, really happy about this.
I know, right? It's like a whole new world nowadays. I told you I was going to expand on jams one way or another. So, you know, like this is the fourth episode of Project Conference. So I want to thank you both for being here and all. And the J360 Legion are going to be happy to get to know you guys because you guys are like one of the most exciting acts that have been on J360 Jams, and not to mention an awesome, incredible cyber pop rock duo, I got to say.
Yes.
You know, you guys have just nailed everything. So it's just been amazing on everything. And we had one heck of a road getting to this episode, but I knew you guys were number four, and I made sure I kept you guys locked in that whole time. So it's been pretty cool having you guys here. But hey, without any further delay, this is all about you guys. This is your story. So I got to know, and I'm sure the world wants to know, what brought you two together? I just got to know, you know?
Facebook. There's a longer story to that, but just like the title of the meeting story. Yeah, so, you know, after a couple of failed cover band projects, I finally gathered enough, you know, courage and motivation and self-confidence to start my own band. And then I put a very nice, you know, like post on Facebook, which was saying something like, singer looking for band members to start a new band. And I put some reference bands into there. I think there were bands like Paramore and New Year's Day, The Pretty Reckless, Paris. And yeah, Sebo, you want to take it from here?
Yeah, and then I saw this post very often. And at this time, I was also looking for a new band because I just split up with one where I played guitar, and I only had one where I played bass, and I wanted to play guitar in a band again. So I saw this post very often, and then I thought to myself, okay, I have to write her, and maybe I can play guitar there. Then we meet up the first time, and yeah, I ended up playing bass.
Bass is good though.
Yeah. Yes, but I wanted to play guitar. Yeah, and the story evolved with the whole band, but that's how we got together. We made a time up, a date with Facebook, and I think in about 24 hours, we managed to make this date, maybe.
Yeah, I think that was pretty special about it because Sebo wrote me in the evening. And, you know, he was like, yeah, I like it. And I sent him a demo song and he was like, this is cool. I can totally imagine that. And then I was like, okay, so you're good to go tomorrow for a rehearsal? And he was like, sure. Nice. So he was really spontaneous, really reliable. So he was really there. He was on time, you know, and it was really uncomplicated with him from the start, which I really, truly appreciated.
Oh, yeah. Awesome. And not to mention becoming legends in the making. Trust me, I've seen it. Especially Mr. Green. awesome bass that you have right there. That was a pretty cool video I saw, like when you guys did a live and we got to see that bass of yours. It has a special string to it, right? Isn't it like a 5-string or 7-string?
It's a 5-string. It's a 5-string, yeah. And the guitar has 7 strings. So nice, yeah, nice. We're at the drop 8 tuning.
Mm-hmm. I was so like, pretty, nah, that's
pretty
wicked.
Low. Pretty low.
Nice, nice. But like I say, you guys have been doing pretty well, and not to mention, I just love your whole element and everything, including the colors. Like whenever I see them colors show up, I'm like, I know who that is. I know who that is. Just everything about y'all is just amazing. Like it just the wonderful mix. Have you guys been touring long? Like how many years?
We've recently hit 4 years, I think. So I think we're celebrating 4 years of Ardenite and a friendship this year. So that's pretty incredible. It's been a bit different in the beginning, but I think that's totally normal. Our whole growth process and finding ourselves, finding our aesthetic and our sound. And, you know, now I think it's running smoother than ever. Actually, today we finally revealed our new studio, which is behind me.
Nice, nice. Loving it.
So that's one of the very exciting things we've been doing the last couple of weeks was building this studio. And that is actually Sebo's guitar over there with the 7 strings. And we're rehearsing. We're rehearsing right now quite a lot.
good. My next question up is like, when is your first album coming? I know it's coming. It's just like, when is that going to hit?
Sebo, you want to respond to that?
So it's planned to release at the end or at the beginning of autumn. Okay. And yeah, but it's still a long way to go. So, but it's pretty much, it's basically it's finished. But yeah, I can't talk about a lot of it. So it's a complicated thing.
Oh yeah,
it's gonna happen. Yeah.
Well, I believe it. I mean, whatever you can give, that's awesome. You know what I mean? I still got tons and tons of jams episodes to do, not to mention the music video version of it. So, hey, we're on the road. We'll ride that wave. You know what I mean?
Yes.
I'm just going to say you heard a lot of it already from the album, but the best things are coming.
Oh, man, I believe it.
So we've been actually working on some of those tracks for over 3 years. So it's like a huge work which is coming together in that debut album. And you know, we actually changed many of the songs along with our own transformation. So some of the songs have been changed over 3 times. So there was quite some work on those. And, you know, now finally we got them in our right cyber pop rock style. And now, like Sebo says, it's only the last 20%, which is like the last kind of tweaks and sparkles. Mm-hmm. And that is what we are going for. We're going for autumn with a release, you know. It depends on a couple of other people, but we will do our very best to release it this autumn.
Hey, I expect no less from the greats. This is going to be awesome, you know?
Yes.
So I can't wait to see what you guys do next from here. But you know what? Why don't we just go ahead and give the audience a taste of what they need to see right now, you know? We'll go ahead and we'll take a look at the music videos. And only thing different this time is that we're actually going to live react to them. So we're going to go ahead and sit back and watch some things. If there's anything you're embarrassed about, well, it's too late for that because we're going to go ahead and watch this stuff. All righty? So the first one that we're going to do, we're going to try to do this in order today. This one is going to be Backstabber because that was one of your first songs when you guys submitted to jams. So I do remember that. And as a matter of fact, we have the music video right here right now. So we're going to go ahead and take it away.
Dear, you're not looking for a friend, but someone you can use and then pretend like everything is okay, as long as you request and they obey. Wait a minute, what's up with all the taking? Maybe that's why your friendships are breaking. Then you're playing the victim once again. I gave you so many shots. You take all that you can get, nothing in return. That's not the way it works. All that envy and scorn, in the blink of an eye, you're gonna be all alone. You can't stop again. You're gonna be all alone, all alone. My life is so much less complicated. I've got rid of you. Got enough chances. Wish you were.
I just gotta say this though, man, Sibo, she got you good.
Yeah. But I deserve it.
Yeah, that was wild, y'all. I really like that. I was like, ooh.
It started to become a bit of a running gag that Sabo always gets like the evil villain roles.
Yeah, it crystallizes always in this way. Somehow.
I mean, you know, you did take the money. I mean, let's just be honest. Oh boy. But I was like, yeah, that was well put together. Everything about that was amazing. And the way you guys sync up and just the synergy is just awesome. Beautifully done, both of you. How long did it take you to produce that video?
Well, I think we shot it in one single day, right?
Yes, the shooting just took one day. I think it was like 11 hours or 14 hours, something like that.
Yes, it was lots of hours, but we shot it in the same room, and we did build all of the sets in the same room. Yeah, so that was special about it.
Wow. Yes.
But how long the whole production was, I can't tell you. I don't know how long.
Well, it was a lot of editing afterwards, and we also had some brainstorming sessions before to discuss this whole storyline.
Definitely, like, and it paid off too, because I was like, yeah, okay. Especially the part where it was Juan in the blonde wig. I was like, yo. So, you know, whatever you guys did right there, you just got to keep doing it. You know what I mean? Speaking of which, I've been meaning to ask. I was going to wait until after we saw all the other videos for this, but I'm going to ask right now. Are there concerts or live streams coming up in the future for you guys?
Yes, for sure. So we are actually rehearsing right now for our next live show, which is in 12 days on the 7th of April. And we're super stoked about that because we didn't play live in over 3 years, I believe. So it's pretty crazy. We're super excited. And with this new home studio, which I got right here, we're planning to do more and more live streams. So you're going to see more and more of us, dear Jay.
Excellent. Excellent. Because I remember going to the first one that you guys did. Oh, I had to be there, y'all. You know what I mean? As soon as I saw that, I was like, yes, yes, let's throw in our support here.
I was so happy to see you there, Jay. I remember it exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was like, look, there they are, working on the magic right now. It was pretty awesome, too, to see you guys do that. And I'm actually going to visit to more of your stuff. I hope to actually catch a live concert of yours, at least in the future. So with the way things are going, that would be really, really nice.
And now, actually, Jay, you just reminded me, I think we didn't get to do any Instagram live stream for our last single. So maybe we'll do one very soon.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Most definitely.
And it's now it's just getting better. Audio quality wise, it's now really set up for a live session.
Cool. Hey, now's the perfect time to flex, okay? That's what I say, you know? Speaking of which, let's see. It's a weird transition on that, but let's go into your next your next video, which is Flowers Don't Care. I had a good one planned on how to do that, but you know, I'll do it for the third one. Speaking of which, so let's go on ahead and jump into Flowers Don't Care and see what's happening, all right?
Yeah.
Take it away.
On the day you went away, 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 there was nothing left to say, nothing to say. There was only pain to feel so real. Splitting up, I wouldn't know where to begin to heal. Ooh.
Very nice, very nice. Hey, nice touch with the art Nightflowers and all, you know? That was really cool. Not to mention, Death likes to party, but he got a job to do. And that's the thing.
That's the thing.
Man, it was awesome. I really do enjoy that music video, too. Well put together and the scenery and everything. Like, I think I was talking with you guys, too, as you were producing that. I remember one time you were. Or I saw one of your videos when you were out there.
It was at the beginning of summer, I think or end of spring.
Yeah.
I think the anniversary for that's coming up soon, right?
Yeah.
That's right. Hey, hey. we'll have to revive it with that occasion, yeah.
You know? Who knows? You probably already did. Like right there, you know, this springtime around here. I think it's changed over there for you guys too, right?
Yeah. Everything is blooming.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, hey, but we didn't get no winter around here, so it's gonna be a very interesting one. That's what I say.
We had snow today.
Oh, you guys did?
Yeah.
We all lucky. You know?
Yeah, I remember when I ordered these flowers in our colors, you know, and then we. You know, they were just ordered from Amazon, so we needed to make them somehow look very nice, like a nice bouquet, you know, like in the video. So I went to them to a real florist, and she looked at me very, very weird when I said, can you please package this plastic flowers? And she was like, really? Like, just package? And I was like, yeah, make them look pretty. And she was quite disturbed.
I mean, you know, but they would know how to decorate that stuff, though. That's the thing. It's like, I mean, I'm still a customer.
It's just like you would go to a restaurant with your own food and say, garnish it, please.
I'm not one to tell on myself, but I did do that one time.
Respect for that. Yeah, actually I felt so bad about you know, only letting her decorate, so I bought some other flowers too, you know, just
you know, tip of the hat and all, you know, like let them know, like, yeah, we commend you for your service, I'll buy one, you know. It's just a well done music video, guys. I mean, like, you just nailing it, like, right then and there. And I like how every single video you do, even the ones that we don't have tonight, are just showing how your art is evolving. And that's really, really cool.
Oh, you saw it really from the Backstabber one to this? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you know, I've been in this game a long time. I see growth and know it, you know. So it's just like amazing how you guys are doing that and everything.
Yeah. By the way, it was pretty hard to organize all the people. That was pretty hard.
That was the toughest challenge about it. Because we needed a location. And then we decided to use Sivo's garden because it's like really beautiful and perfect for that. However, it's quite far away from Vienna on the countryside. And then it was a real challenge to bring some motivated people over there. So it was tough.
Yeah. Hey, you guys nailed it, though. It was like, you know, that's the beauty of production. And it's like a lot going on. But then after a while, you know, you just get through it. And it actually works out in the end for everybody. So, which is really beautiful, too. You know? Oh, by the way, speaking of which, what is one thing that fans can do to stay connected to you guys? You know, is there a newsletter or like any sort of announcement when you guys do videos and all, like special messaging service?
We're working on a newsletter right now, so we don't have one yet, but we will set up one really soon. Our main platform in the meantime is still Instagram. So that's the place where you can get the newest news, especially in the stories, in the vlogs that we post from time to time there. So that would be it right now. And for the future, a newsletter so that we are not so dependent on, you know, certain social media.
I totally get it because, well, you know, for obvious reasons. But yeah, you know, there's just ways of doing that. And I'm looking forward to it because when you guys get that ready, I'm signing up. Simple as that.
I'm really happy about it, Jade.
I don't know if I can talk about it, but we are planning to put up together a Patreon.
That's good. Yeah. That's mm-hmm. wonderful too. So, yeah, I'll be sure to keep an eye out for that as well.
Oh, so, yeah. there you get some special content.
See, I'm with it. Yeah. I'm with it.
We can talk about it.
Oh yeah, okay. Yeah. Whatever you guys feel comfortable talking about, please do. This is about you guys, you know. And the way to go about that is not leave anybody out of the loop. You know what I'm saying? So, because after all, you don't want to be you're so dumb. You know what I'm saying? Like things like that, which is the name of the music video that's coming up right now.
So smooth.
So we'll go ahead and jump up into there. Oh, don't worry. We got one more after this one. So it's like, but I got a special treat for that one. But yeah, you don't want to be left behind, you know? So the next one we got coming up is You're So Dumb by Ardenite right here. All right, take it away. Fine, I'll buy the album. Jeez. You know, it's like y'all did a great job on that one too. Oh my god, like fantastic work with that. Like in the dreads and the context too, Juana and Sibo. Oh. Awesome job with the Cheetah's jacket and everything, man. That was just
that was funny wearing that.
How did you feel, Sibo, wearing that?
It was interesting. Everybody was looking at me. It was so funny. One time, like a grandma came up to me and suddenly she like looks behind her and says, I'm supposed to be wearing that.
Yeah, I mean, it was stylish.
Yeah,
you wore it better.
See, that's how you do it, my man. That's how you do it. I was like, okay. And then we're bringing all that back in style.
Yeah, that's also why the Korn t-shirt, because I remember when Fieldy also got on stage with his coat. That was funny.
Hey, like I said, that was iconic too. Like the other two were great, but that right there, that's definitely an iconic picture of y'all, especially when Juana looked like a mental patient there for a little bit. That was like, yeah. All right, we're caught up. I'm with it. I'm in the vibe.
Yeah, the main inspiration of this video, especially for me, were one of the first videos of Marilyn Manson, like Sweet Dreams and Tourniquet.
Beautiful got people. That vibe in there. Yeah.
Yeah, that was my idea. Yeah.
Nailed it. That was it.
struggled so hard with those contact lenses. Mm-hmm. Like you wouldn't even imagine. Like I think I struggled about half an hour with the first one. And then I thought, like, okay, I got the hang of it. So the second one was so much worse. Yeah. When I had it in, like half of my makeup was gone.
Oh man, contacts are the worst sometimes, especially like when you're doing acting and all, and like, you know, you can't see in them or anything. It's like, oh man, just get the shot right the first time, you know?
and that wasn't even like the worst part, because after that I couldn't see almost anything. Oof. And so I could see about 20% of my usual, you know, sight capacity. And we were shooting in a dark basement. So basically, I couldn't see anything.
It wasn't a basement, it was an attic.
Oh, an attic, yeah. So still dark.
Is what it's called.
And Sebo was really like holding my arm and, you know, taking me from one place to the other through the attic. So I will remember that one. Yeah.
Oh man!
And the attic was very scary. Well, scary, but there were like birds everywhere.
What?
Yeah,
so, like real skeletons. So it really fit the mood. And,
yeah.
Goodness, where are we all filming at exactly? Like, you know what I mean? Shoot, I can only imagine where it took place, if you guys can divulge that news.
So it was actually a professional photo studio, which was renting that attic, but they took it like really seriously, right? Like they wouldn't clean up the skeletons to make it look creepy. So, okay.
Mm. We'll work
not
with
touching
it.
That.
Man, that is I mean, you know, it's morbid, but it's amazing. You know what I mean? you know, I was like, yeah, okay, you guys nailed every bit of that. So I'm wondering if I actually did air that one on. Yes, I did.
Very good.
You know, just making sure, like, I got all ducks in a row because, you know, I can't divulge all my secrets either. So, like, it's one of those kind of things. But also, I've tried to ask this to every members of the Jam Fam. Like, what platform do you guys prefer, Spotify or Bandcamp?
That's a good question.
mean for the band or personally, as a consumer?
I would say for the band, actually.
Mm-hmm. I would say for the music, Spotify is our main platform. But for the support, it will be Patreon. We are working on it. So yeah, at the moment, of course, we're getting a bit of cash from Bandcamp, which is nice. Like, you know, we appreciate every kind of support. Patreon will be the main place to support us very soon, because, you know, it's on a monthly basis and there's different tiers and you get something new in return, you know, not just the music, which is available everywhere else. So it's going to be kind of a nice exchange situation.
Very, very nice. Definitely look forward to that. I wear my Arden Knight shirt with pride, all right? That'd be the way. I figured I'd go ahead and ask you guys that because, you know, usually results vary. So it's always like some people like one program more or another person likes another distributor more. It's just always a question to ask. So, you know, different strokes for different folks. Oh, and speaking of which, let me see, because like, it's interesting because see, when you look back at this, it's gonna look like I'm looking up, but it's because your monitor's like right there, and then like everything else is looking over here. So you know, it's one of those kind of things. But also, let's see, what else do I have? Is there a main website or so where people can reach you guys at?
Yes, absolutely. Our home website is ardenite.net. And we're keeping that pretty fresh. So you can get all the links there. You can get the latest story behind the singles there. And yeah, basically from there, you can get on all our other platforms. And that's
we have a
already
shop there.
Ooh, yes, exactly. We also have a Shopify merch shop there where you can get your merch and not only t-shirts, but also hoodies and self-painted paintings.
Oh, yes, yes, about the paintings. Oh, yeah.
Oh, you have questions about the paintings? Thanks so much, Jay. So I really enjoy, you know, painting as well. It's one of my other passions. And I feel, you know, like as a creative person, you can have multiple channels, right, to let that art flow out of you. And speaking of flow, we use those paintings also for music video background. Mm-hmm. It all started with our first single, which was Love Drug Addict. And we had some of these paintings in the background there. And actually, Sebo painted them black. So there are some recycled paintings in there. And Sebo painted over them completely black. And then I dipped a hand in pink color, a hand in turquoise color, and then I was just making some abstract art over that background. And yes, those are also available as merch.
nice. Oh, see, now I gotta look around and see what walls don't have anything I made on it, so I can go ahead and get stuff that you guys made and put them right there.
Yeah, absolutely. If you want some Ardenite spirit in your home, Jay.
you know it, next to the album and all, yes. Oh man. So hey, speaking of which, as a token to all of people who appeared on Project Conference and all, and since it's the last video of the time, I want you guys to introduce it. All right, it'd be pretty cool if you both did, or if one of you do. It's the latest one you made, actually.
Oh, okay. What do you think, Sebo? You want to do it, or should I?
It's better when you do it.
I actually think Sebo is also very good at introducing things, but it will be my pleasure. Good. So the latest single, you mean, right? The latest one you got prepared for us. Yeah, our latest single is called Don't Wanna Stay Friends. It came out on Valentine's Day this year. And yeah, it was actually an anti-Valentine's Day song. We wanted to, you know, give a virtual hug to all the people who maybe hate Valentine's Day or are spending it alone against their will. And, you know, we wanted to, you know, be there for all of these people and, you know, like show them that it's fine and it's even better to be single than to be with the wrong person. So that's what it's all about in that single.
Awesome. Well, you know, hey, let's just go ahead and fire it up for the people, shall we?
Yes.
All right, take it away.
I wanted a house, I wanted a flat. Let's live with you.
Hey, that is awesome. You know, if I was there during the production of your video, and don't take this to heart, but where those ladies are, I would slide right over there like this. You know what I mean? just for a moment. I just wanted to be in the video. That's all.
Draw me like one of your French ladies.
Yeah, exactly. you know, got to make that magic moment.
Yeah, we'd love to have you in one of our videos, Jay.
Hey, you know, as things grow and everything, I don't mind making cameo appearances popping up. Awesome job with all of that, too. I was like, looking at that, I was like, wow. You know, they do need an anthem, and that is very important because, let's just say, you know, holidays can be hard for people, especially like when it goes to Christmas, to Valentine's. So it actually makes a lot of sense. And that was wonderful video, you know. And there are some people who just are not, you know, satisfied with who they have and all that stuff. So it actually works out pretty good. And like the way it was all designed and everything, I was like, really? Who friend zoned you? And nice shredding. Thank you. I mean, you're welcome. Nice shredding, by the way, Mr. Green. You did pretty good there for the middle riffs and all, and not to mention great vocals, Miss White. You know, just an incredible job.
Thank you so much. And we're also so thankful to the amazing girls in the video, which are actually friends of mine and of ours. And, you know, like they dedicated the whole day for the video. And, you know, like they did it out of pure passion and support. And I think that was incredible how much dedication they put into that. And another nice fact, we shot the whole video on a single bed. So that was it. Did you notice that, Jay?
I didn't know that. You know what I mean? I was just like, I'm so into the vibe and everything. I didn't take the time to detail it this time, you know?
I mean, it's not the first video where we did a lot in the bed. Like, End of the World. There was also the whole dark scenes are just on the bed. And I think nobody is ever going to notice this, that it's on the bed. Because it looks like it's like in space or in some kind of dimension.
Okay, well, you know, sometimes that actually ain't far from the truth. But you know, the thing is, it's like, but you know, like, yeah, I'll be sure to look out for that video too. You know, always go back and see what's up. But definitely, they can catch all your music videos on your site and YouTube, of course, right? So,
yes.
You know, see exactly how things have grown. If anything, we gave them a taste tonight. But what were you saying?
And talking about YouTube, I wanted to add, we're actually very close to 500 YouTube subscribers. Ooh. So if you enjoyed what you saw here today, like maybe give us a subscribe on YouTube. And we are actually preparing a very special video to celebrate this milestone. So the sooner we reach it, you know, we will post that video. And it's a gift for you, Jay, and for all of our amazing community.
Nice. That's what I like to see. All about that. That is so cool. I mean, a special treat to everybody because, like, even those that aren't Ardenites, they will be by the time this lands. So that's all there is to it. They're growing into this. You guys are going up to the top. So, you know, just stay on the bead and everything. You know what I mean?
Oh, I love it how you believe in us, Jay. And we feel it. We really feel it. And we will keep going, you know, like there's no stopping at this point.
Right. I mean, like, you got all this right here. It's just like, yes.
yes.
You know?
Yes.
Like, and like, I like how your sound changes all the time. And like that's just wonderful. Because you got some, I hate to say this because this ain't the kind of show. You know, I got multiple shows. But I'm like this. I'm like, there are people that just, they'd stay in the same spot. But you guys keep pushing yourselves. And that's the most beautiful thing. As artists, we're supposed to do that.
Yeah.
You'll actually be surprised regarding the next single.
Oh.
always always up for surprising you. Yeah. So get ready for that.
I can't wait. I can't wait. Like, well, you know, for time's table's sake, like, when's that supposed to land anyway?
Let me think about it. So we have the end of March. I think maybe somewhere around May latest will be realistic. What do you think, Sebo?
Yeah, that could be it. But yeah, it depends on some stuff.
Yeah,
the main thing is the music is here more or less, but we have to think about the video.
Yes. Okay. Mm-hmm.
That's cool.
So right now we're getting ready to brainstorm for the video. Like we mentioned, first we do a big brainstorming, then we shoot the video, and then, you know, we edit it, and then it's yours.
Hey, by all means. I mean, I'm looking forward to the next one. So it's like, as soon as you bring it on, it's like, yes, great. Bring it right on in. I'll put it right on the list. You know how it goes.
But at the meantime,
we'd love to send it to you.
At the meantime, you could watch the other videos, because we have more videos for the same songs, like lyric videos, behind-the-scenes videos. And yeah, also some other piano versions or a cinematic video and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I actually checked our YouTube channel today, and I think we have over 150 videos on there. So I think you'll have enough to keep you entertained for a while.
Oh man, I mean, especially like with your piano medleys, I remember seeing a few of them. Those are pretty good.
Oh.
Like, I'm like, yes. So, okay. You know, like right then and there, like I've been aware now. Come on. You know, I've been looking like, I always see what you guys are up to. So it's like, yeah. And, you know, fantastic job. And of course, you know, as much as I love how this episode is going, we're going to have to go ahead and tie it up here, you know?
Oh.
So, hey, but don't worry though. As you guys keep being in the biz, I'm still in the biz, so we can do follow-ups and all that. That's just the way it goes, you know?
We'd love to do a follow-up, maybe next year or something. That would be great.
Yeah, I see nothing but greatness here. So it's like, you know, just got to keep on going with that. And like I said, we gave them a taste tonight, but there's going to be a lot more coming. I can see it.
And yeah. I love how all of us are growing together. Like I also remember where I met you, Jay, and I think it's just incredible what you have built. And this is how we will keep growing together.
You know it.
Yeah.
Hey, gotta go up. You know what I mean? That's the way. We're scaling this mountain.
Yes.
But definitely, it was awesome having you guys here on Project Conference tonight. And wish you nothing but the best. You guys want to go ahead and discuss like what sites that people can connect with you guys on? I know we talked about it before, but go ahead and let them know a few things, like such as like where they can go ahead and interact with your music, all that. If you got like a link tree or what you want to drop at the bottom, please just let me know.
In our Instagram profile, in our bio, you can find our link tree, and we will also send it to Jay so you can post it underneath the video. And yeah, there's everything there, especially our YouTube, our Spotify, you know, our webpage where you can find the merch, and it's very soon our Patreon. So those are our main platforms.
Awesomeness. Don't you guys forget, like, or hold on, what camera am I looking at? This one. Okay, so, and don't you guys forget, as a matter of fact, show your support for every person that has appeared on Project Conference, especially R tonight, and the description, and it'll be in the description box below where you can follow all of their links and everything. Like, stay in step and show your support. Make things grow full circle, if you will. All right. And also, don't forget to subscribe to J360T because I'm a no. All right. Well, all in all, though, you guys take care of yourselves, and we will catch you all later.